kung hindi kasabwat yung mga iba dyan sa pulis. Kaya't kailangan natin tignan na mabuti sino ba talaga ang kasabwat dyan, sino ba talaga ang involved, at sinong hindi na talaga pwede magserbisyo dahil associated na sila sa mga drug lord. So that is just like, we are just cleansing the ranks and trying to see and making sure. Hello, good afternoon. As you have seen, as soon as I got back from China last night, I scheduled a visit here to the airport to get a briefing from the airport authorities, especially with the Secretaries Jimmy Bautista and Secretary Ivan Uy, for the technical aspects of the problem that we saw on New Year's Day. Now, as far as we can determine, as far as we have done everything to return operations back to normal. And right now, we can say that overall, the national system was down for about six and a half hours on January 1. At nakabalik naman kaagad. Ngayon, ang pinag-usapan namin ay kung paano tiyakin na hindi na mangyari ulit. At mayroong mga pieces of equipment na mukhang nagka-problema, kaya nagkaganto, kaya naputulan ang kuryente, kaya nag-down yung buong system. So, I think for now, we'll be all right. But we are planning already on the future redundancies for the system. So, kung meron mangyari ulit na ganito, meron tayong kaagad na kapalit. Hindi na tayo aabot ng 6 na oras. Siguro mahaba na yung ilang minuto lang. Well, UPS is an uninterrupted power supply. So, for more or less, dapat uninterrupted talaga. It's extremely important, especially during Christmas season. At alam naman natin, napakarami ng mga Pinoy na lumilipad mula sa abroad at pumupunta sa kanilang mga probinsya. So now we are back to normal operations. But there is a lot of work that we need to do dahil sari-sari ang problema. There are technical problems that we need to attend to. There are contractual problems that we also need to attend to. So all of these things we will have to attend to immediately. Ang sinabi ko lang kay Sec Jimmy is to make sure that we fast track all of whatever negotiations we have with our with the equipment suppliers who can help us with the upgrades, who can help us with the upgrades both for the software and the hardware of our equipment. And beyond that is to have a proper backup system so that if the whole system fails, like it did on January 1, we have a complete system ready to go. Yun lamang, that might take a little time, but that is something that we will try to fast track as quickly as possible. I can say that considering how big the problem was, I think that the airport authorities, our cabinet secretaries and all those who were involved in returning the system back have done a reasonably good job. At 6 hours is rather a short time considering how much needed to be done to get the system back up into working condition. So that's how it is. There is going to be more on this in the future, as I said. We started by talking about the technical problems that happened in January 1. Then I asked them to brief me on what exactly is the situation now. And the situation now is that we are back to normal operations. And then, of course, what do we need to do in the long term to make sure that this doesn't happen again, certainly, especially not at the high traffic season like happened to us in January 1.
Yeah.